Sometimes when you're listening to something that is not really interesting, it can go in one ear and go out the other. But I'm glad you're here because that means you're interested in learning how to do that animation in Final Cut Pro. Let's get it. So we have our clip on the timeline, and let's grab the basic title from the title generator. Click and drag it on the timeline, and I'm gonna place it right after I say in one ear, or somewhere around that. The plan is we're gonna animate that text first from this side to this side, and then we're gonna simply create a mask in between. Yeah, and it should work. It's gonna work. To animate the text, just create a keyframe at the beginning of the animation by clicking here, and then go to where you want to end the animation. Okay, so now that the playhead is where you want it to be, just click and drag the X position to the left until you're satisfied. And there's your simple animation. Now let's create the mask. It's in the effects, masks, and I'm going to use a shape mask. I think it should work with what we're trying to do here today. And you see this arrow right here next to the position parameters. This will bring you to the keyframes you created because you want to work within that animation. So click on it and go to the first keyframe. And let's start playing with the mask. I'm going to try to make it look rectangular by clicking and dragging this white dot right here. There you go. And then I'm going to position it on the path of the title right here. Let's adjust the size to fit the length of my face because we want to make it look like it goes behind or through my face. By the way, guys, if you want a more precise animation, you need to use the draw mask tool instead and just draw around the object. Yeah. Anyway, we have our mask here and we are going to animate this mask. We're still at the beginning of the animation, so click on the transforms option of the mask and create a keyframe. Then let's click on this arrow to go to the next keyframe, which is the end of our animation. And we're gonna move the mask until it gets back to the length of my head. Now we also have a mask that goes the same direction as the title. Okay, let's look at the result. Not bad. Notice, guys, that this is a very short animation, so I'm just using the first and the last keyframe of the title. Now, if it was a longer animation, if the object moves a lot, you would need to create more keyframes with the mask, maybe every 3 to 4 frames, and follow the object. You get the idea. Masking can be really cool. If you guys get any value from this one, you know what to do. Subscribe and check out these other videos for Final Cut Pro users, and I will see you guys in the next one. Hopefully. Peace.